あれ？なんでここにいるの？
Hello out there in YouTube land. This is Yuri Jacobs from the YT Gamers Network bringing you another game through commentary. Today I'm going to be playing as Reco in Mushihime-sama Futari Black Label by Cave and AMI. If you or anyone who is sensitive or has photosensitive seizures to this game or any other game that has bright effects or too much effects, then this is not the video for you. You may want to consider to go to another channel that has lesser effects. So, let's begin this game. In this game, I will be playing in Maniac mode with Reco. Mushihime-sama Futari is a bullet hell game shooter by Cave. It was released in arcades on October 27, 2006, and is the sequel to Mushihime-sama on the 21st of April 2009, it was announced at Microsoft's spring press conference in Japan that Mushihime-sama Futari would be released on the Xbox 360 in Japan on November 26th of 2009. But we are talking about the Black Label version of this game, so I'm going to be talking about that. I will talk about more of Mushihime-sama Futari in another time. This Black Label is a limited edition arcade release of the game that was released in December 11th, 2007. Only 150 Black Label boards released, which included the following changes. Coming up, stages 2, 3, and 5 will have different color palettes. There is no shot type selection other than the previous games. The resulting shot type is a mixture of both normal and abnormal modes from previous games. And why on earth am I seeing a near T-Rex in a game that's a bullet hell game that shouldn't be there that involves bugs? I'll never know, guys. I will never know. Oh my god! But anyway, that was stage one, by the way, people. Imagine a robotic dinosaur in the 21st century. Oh man, we would be in big trouble at that time. As I said, the resulting shot type is a mixture of normal and abnormal modes from previous games, and is much more powerful than in other versions. Both characters move a lot faster in the Black Label compared to 1.5. And the more enemies, and more enemies fire bullets. The scoring system has changed. In the original mode, the counter changes every 3,000 gems, with an added audible warning when the counter changes. Blue gems worth more points are awarded when enemies are killed from very close range. When the stage counter is above 9,999, gems are shedded off enemies if you are very close to them. The rank, in this case bullet speed, increases when the stage counter is above 9999 in proportion to the overall counter. In Maniac mode, as you guys see here, and what I'm playing, you gain lots of gems by killing enemies with the C button instead of the A button when the meter is red. The amount of gems is proportionate to how close you are to the enemy. The God mode, replacing Ultra mode, uses a slightly modified Maniac mode score system. The maximum multiplier is increased by 30,000. Additional gems are gained by killing enemies with the C button at close range. Only kicks in once the multiplier is above 9999. Unfortunately, it has a much more slowdown compared to Ultra Mode, and it's also much easier compared to Ultra Mode. Some players consider version 1.01's Maniac Mode to be harder. Far harder than God mode here. Now, as I stated, this game is one of several of Cave's bullet hell games. But in the genre of the definition of this game, it belongs to the maze bugs area. That means it's part of Centipede, Millipede, the those two games, those two parts of those games, actually I shouldn't say that because it's part of the genre of games, Centipede, Millipede, and Mushihime-sama Futari is one of those games. But I am jumping ahead of myself. We'll talk more about that when I play Centipede or Millipede, and I'll have to get a trackball for my mouse since I do not have a trackball to play those two games. But back on topic here, we're going into stage 3 right now. A new true boss, Spiritual Larsa, was added. She can only be reached by completing God mode without dying. She is considered easier than Ultra Mode's true last boss. There is another Black Label. This is Black Label, another version. This version of Black Label was released on November 27th of 2009, and it was intended for international release, but not for sale in Japan. In this version, the bosses have reduced health compared to the standard Black Label release, as you see here. Now, I'm playing this game on MAME, Thunder MAME 32UI Plus to be exact. This Black Label another version, I'm not sure if MAME will emulate it at any point, but it's still too early to tell, and we'll find out if it's emulated, and I can show you guys what that game is. Let's talk about the Xbox 360 port. The Xbox 360 release includes version 1.5, Novice and a range game modes. Black Label can be downloaded for 1,200 Microsoft points from the Xbox Live Marketplace under the misspelled title Mushihime-sama Futari Black Label. Note that the Xbox Live Marketplace purchase is for add-on only, not for the full game. The first print editions include version 1.01 via a download code. The limited edition release for the Xbox 360 came with an arranged soundtrack CD, an Xbox 360 faceplate, and either a version A Reco or version B Palm and Aki telephone card. A platinum edition was released later. All versions of the game are region-free. The player can select between original arcade graphics and new high-resolution graphics. You can play the game in Tate on a vertical monitor with numerous graphical options, including scanlines. The Xbox 360 exclusive range mode allows one player only to play through the game with special rules. If a player is hit, they do not die, and instead a bomb is launched on contact. Unless the player does not have any bombs, the player is allowed to switch between controlling Reco or Palm, with the non-active character ghosting alongside the active one while shooting. Changing also generates a temporary shield. Selecting shot type is not available in this mode, however. But we will continue on with that as I explain more and more about the iOS port. As we get ready to enter stage 4 of this video game. I wouldn't call it underrated or overrated by any means, but this is just my opinion. In April 2012, Cave released a port of the game on the iOS platforms. It was titled Bug Princess 2. Mushihime-sama was also released on platforms titled Bug Princess. The game includes a weight control option where the player can make the bullets slow down when numerous. This is technically the first time the game was released internationally. On June of the same year, the Black Label version of the game was released globally under the name Bug Princess 2 Black Label. Now, talking about the characters of this game, because I won't mention them later on in the next game through I try and play. An extra character is added to this game. The basic plot revolves around the death of the antagonist from the very first one, Aki, and his mother, Larsa, going insane and seeking revenge on Reco for allegedly killing him. Her younger son, Hom, goes in search of Reco to learn the truth about his brother on his own. Eventually, Reco finds Hom lost far from home and the two become friends, with Hom learning what happened to Aki was not her fault. Together, they aim to travel back to Hom's home and stop the madness of Larsa. Now again, I'm playing as Reco on Kaneiro. Kaneiro fires spread shots, while Palm on Hero fires concentrated shots. The Mushihime-sama Futari soundtrack originally was released on CD on May 30th, 2007 in Japan and was published by Cave. The Black Label soundtrack was released in 2009 as Mushihime-sama double arranged album, along with arranged compositions of the original Mushihime-sama. The reception this game got of the Japanese video game magazine Famitsu Xbox 360 Monthly awarded the game a score of 8.876, while Weekly Famitsu gave the game score of 8.777, and Ollie Clark Smith of NTSC UK rated the game a 9 out of 10. So basically, this game is more awesome than the games I recently played on. I'm normally a classic gamer. I play shoot-em-ups like Chopper Eye, Galaga, Galaxian, Centipede, and Millipede I was talking about. But in all due respect, this game has beautiful graphics, and the gameplay itself is more amazing. But just as long as you have a good computer, and I mentioned about the slowdown rate. If you have an older computer and your CPU slows down because of this game, that's how it is. But I have a 2-year-old computer right here, and I got about a 4.0 CPU. And apparently, this game can slow down just quite a bit, and sometimes you'll be hearing a lot of sound distortion. That's because I got to get a new motherboard for my computer right now. So right now I'm in the middle of trying to get a new motherboard for my computer until then. So I'm sorry I have to go off topic, but it's a living when you play on video games on your computer instead of the arcades. I retired from the arcades at age 22. And now we are entering stage 5 of this game. Again, this is Maniac mode on Mushihime-sama Futari Black Label. And the boss we're going to be facing is Larsa. She is the mother of Paul. She is the main antagonist of the story. She seeks revenge on Reco for the death of her son, Aki. She pilots her ship, her boss's stage 5 ship. I shouldn't say ship because it really isn't a ship. It's the Dragon Imperion. Sometimes I wonder whether or not this game can do a lot more better. If it expanded a lot, if it had a 6th stage to it, I think it would be more great. But original mode, maniac mode, and god mode are like easy to normal, then hard, then to hardest. Maniac mode right here is at hard level. So I'm playing at a hard level instead of original mode. And why do I see more dinosaurs in this game? What is this? But anyway, guys, I'm going to give you a little challenge. I want you guys, whether you have MAME or another emulator, I want you to try and go and play this game, Mushihime-sama Futari Black Label, and choose either Maniac Mode or God Mode. See how well you can get to the end without dying. And since, unfortunately, YouTube does not have a video response, has been eliminated for quite some time, I want you to send me your YouTube link to your video underneath the description, underneath my video that I have now. This is a challenge to you guys. See how far you can get in Mushihime-sama Futari Black Label. See how far you can get. See how well you can handle the bullet hell that is of this game. Either through Maniac Mode or God Mode, like I said. And I have seen Nack's video by Icarus FW on this game when he went to God Mode, and I must say, I am amazed at what he's done. In case you haven't seen it, go over to Icarus FW's channel. Find it under Special Demonstrations. It's number 6. It's this game. I believe it's 1.0 or Black Label. I believe it's 1.0. 1.0 or 1.5. I might have to check it out. But I'm sure it's 1.0 or 1.5. Now, if you like my video, if you like any of my videos, please rate and comment. And don't forget to subscribe to me. My name is Yuri Jacobs. My link is youtube.com/MissYuriJacobs. That's M-I-S-S, all one word. You can subscribe underneath. Just push the subscribe button underneath my videos. Or go to my channel and click on subscribe underneath my banner. Also, If you like to join Freedom, because I am partnered with Freedom through White Team Gamers, then click on the referral link next to the channel trailer on the right-hand side on my channel. That way, you could join Freedom, as well as you could join White Team Gamers if you like. I won't go through Larsa twice here because this only goes through once. If I was in the God mode instead of Maniac mode, I possibly would go through her twice. I possibly would go through her either twice or a third time, depending on what it is. But check out the game here. Just type in Mushihime-sama Futari, doesn't matter if it's Black Label or 1.0, on YouTube, and check out other users that play this game and see how it compares to mine. I would like your feedback on this video, because this is my second vocal commentary on this, and usually I do text commentaries instead of talking over the games, because talking over the games while playing them is very difficult on my part. I can't multitask that. So I appreciate the feedback that you guys give me, and don't hesitate. I really need some feedback. Well, we are at the end of this game, and I really appreciate it. I think this game, I wouldn't say it's on top, but this and Donpachi, or Donpatch, as you would call it, pretty much stands out by itself. But I really appreciate this game. Much more nice. Nice graphics, nice gameplay. I don't see any errors so far, no issues with it. Just the lagging, just the slowdown, it needs to be taken care of next time. Well, I hope that you guys enjoyed my game through. This has been Mushihime-sama Futari Black Label, as I played as Reco in the Maniac mode. I want to thank you guys for your support, and I hope to see you again pretty soon. Like I said, I may be doing another text commentary. It depends on which games I'm going to be doing text commentaries or vocal commentaries on, but I'm going to mix them up. I won't do it too much, because I'm doing this unscripted. So, until next time, I wish you all a happy and safe Halloween. Go out trick-or-treating. Don't be mean to other neighbors. Have a good time at your parties, and be safe and happy. So until next time from the YT Gamers Network, this is Yuri Jacobs signing off. Good luck. And good gaming.